Que lo que hay, mi gente? Freddy Flame, a.k.a. FredEFuego, Flame Hot Entertainment. Today we are in NukeTown playing Headquarters. The player is NATO. He is going to be beastifying. I am going to be commentating. I had the privilege to download this game from him. And the game is called, this video is called 74 and what? Say what? I'm just trying to have fun with this video. Alright, as you can see, I'm trying to find NATO on the screen. And there he goes. So now, as you can see, it's going to be one of those games where it's going to be a high kill count, high death count. Look at this. Oh, off the school bus for the brick. But the guy came back to the same guy and he just stayed there. Look at this. One, two. Oh, nothing but kneecaps and ankles. Kneecaps and ankles, ladies and gentlemen. This is what's going down. He is hugging the school bus, and it's not the short bus. So, this is one of my favorite maps on this game. Even though I don't play, I've never really played it a lot, but this is one of my favorite maps on this game due to the fact that it is a cul-de-sac with a barrier. I mean, you ain't got much space to begin with. A cul-de-sac. You only usually have like, what, maybe four houses max in a cul-de-sac. You can't go into the backyard of either of the two end houses at the end of the street, or is it one house at the end of the street? You can't go into that backyard. That's closed off. So all you have is two backyards, one on the left, one on the right, and the houses that you could go into, which are the left and the right house. So this basically breaks down the fact that it's hard to camp. If you got a good team laying it down, you might be able to. But that being said, most of the time you don't, because everybody's playing for themselves. They're not playing like teamwork or whatever. So I love this map. This map was made really good. I like the way it looks. You know, 60s look. It's in a Nevada Valley somewhere, made up makeshift town. They're gonna nuke this shit at the end of the match. Look at this, RPG to the top of the dome piece, and this dude just let him walk right past and pwn his ass. That's what I'm talking about. But yeah, and you can see too when you're going towards the left house, you see the double rainbow. And if you don't know what the double rainbow video is, you need to YouTube it, Google it, and you'll find out. You've had people do parodies of it. Oh, look at that. Well, this is going to be one of those games. I do have two people that I know that are in this game, Flesh UK and NATO. And I don't have this game anymore. I did for the first 2 or 3 weeks of its release. I had game flyed it. Not my cup of tea, but I am not a fanboy, so I'm willing to work with anything I got. You know, I'm really open-minded. So, you know, just because I don't like it doesn't mean you, the viewer, won't like it. You know, it's a personal preference. Damn. He's getting a lot of people, man. Look at this. Look at this dude. Oh, look at it. You missed him. I do say, NATO, if you're listening, you need to look more to your, a little bit more to your left and right, because you have some people creeping up on you, like this dude right in front of you. But you're going to see a lot of times that he does, the way he does get killed is usually from his peripheral view. And, I don't know. Maybe he's, you know, very focused on what he has in front of him. But, you know, I can't do any better, so I can't talk shit about him. He's beastifying compared to how I've done it. I've only gone par on this map, and if you could go back to my other video on this, is par on NukeTown, going par on NukeTown. And you can see, I think that went like 27 and 27. But, yeah, he's, you know, as me as playing this game, I can't do any better. I can't talk shit. I don't know what kind of setup he has going on here, and I don't really do the setup thing. I'm just talking shit while he's playing. You see that spy plane up in the air? Ain't that a bitch? They stay with a spy plane in there. Oh, he got shot down. Care package. You ever seen one of those videos where a care package just lands on the dude that's calling in the care package right on his fucking head and he just dies? That's like the most funniest shit ever. Oh, napalm strike. Missed everybody. Oh. Well, I tend to like, when I do play this game, I tend to do exactly what he's doing. I run back and forth, the house. I don't like to camp it out on any specific spot. But I don't like to get caught up in the backyards because, you know, you get napalms or, you know, chopper gunner and stuff like that. And that's where you spawn up from. So if you get caught back there, man, and you got one of those two situations going on, it's a done data. Come on, get it. Headquarters secured. Look at that. 1, 2, 3, 4. Four dudes. Throw a grenade, you'll hit somebody. Look at that. I don't see. I just seen him shoot at the air and kill somebody. I don't know, man. Sometimes I wonder about this game. Oh, that sounded like a chopper gunner. Yeah, that is a chopper gunner. I hear it. Oh, see that? Look at that. Came right from his peripheral. Ah, dude tried a knife and missed. Got bullets. So, tell me what y'all are like about this game so much. Why do y'all gravitate so much to the Call of Duty franchise? What is it that makes this game so great compared to other shooters? And why does everybody think this is like the end-all be-all to all first-person shooters? And, you know, even though they release one every year, and pretty much almost the same exact thing every year, except for a couple few variations. From what I see, it seems like every time I look at the game, it's running off basically the same game engine. So wouldn't y'all like to see this run on a new updated game engine made from scratch? Don't you think that you, the consumer, the payer of the game, deserves better? Deserves them to break it back from scratch and do it from scratch and get more out of the game, get more out of the systems that run the game? That's just my opinion. I just like to know from your standpoint, the people that actually play this game, the people that actually love this game. That being said, just let me know what's going on. I like to leave an open dialogue, an open forum. So this is what I'm doing. Oh, look, get him, shoot him down. Oh, he missed. What's it called? Anyways, who out there is going to be getting the Killzone 2 beta? I mean, not the Killzone 2 beta, the Killzone 3 game. I'm going to be looking to play seriously, competitively, is over the age of 21, and is looking for a clan. I have a Killzone 3 forum up for my clan, and I am recruiting, and I have a video on my YouTube. You can check it out. It's, Killzone 3 clan recruitment. And are y'all looking forward to the next installment of Call of Duty? And what do you expect from the next installment of Call of Duty? Do you, like I said, do you want to see it on a new game engine? Do you want to see it, you know, what do you want to see taken out or put into it? And, you know, just a lot of things I think could be so much more better with this game. But that's just me. I actually wish they kind of slowed it down just a tad bit. A tenth of the speed on the character movement. Make it look a lot more human. Looks like the movement just looks too quick to me. I've never seen people move that quick. Unless you're like on crack or meth or you're on cocaine or something. Well, this is my boy Nato bringing you some headquarters on NukeTown, and the video is 74 and what? on NukeTown. And I hope y'all enjoy this video, man. Leave your comments, rate, comment, subscribe. This is for all you Call of Duty fans out there. Don't ever say I ain't ever bring you no Call of Duty games or any of that stuff. Let me know. Let me know what you think of my homeboy's gameplay and how he did. Let him know. Go to his channel. He's somewhere on here. I put his link to his channel in the description bar. So, peace, love, and hair grease. If you ain't doing it, you better get gaming. And haters, all y'all haters out there, keep on hating. It's your mofo job. Peace. Enemy spy plane above.
Headquarters located. Package ready for delivery. Mark the DZ. Friendly care package on the way. Target down. Hostile jamming our radar. Target neutral. Care package ready for delivery. Mark the DZ. Enemy spy plane incoming. Enemy down.
Man down. Kill confirmed.
Headquarters online. Friendly RCXD deployed. Care package ready for direction. Show us where you want it. Care package ready for direction. Show us where you want it.
Enemy down!
Friendly spy plane inbound. Spy plane standing by. Spy plane standing by. Headquarters located. Friendly spy plane inbound. Care package ready for direction. Show us where you want it. Cobra on the way. Enemy spy plane incoming. Friendly care package on the way. Friendly care package inbound. Counter spy plane up. They're blind. Our counter spy plane's in the air. Spy plane ready for deployment. Enemy's jamming our radar. Spy plane standing by. Spy plane standing by. Friendly spy plane inbound. Spy plane standing by. Spy plane standing by. Heads up, enemy RCXD. Enemy SAM turret incoming.
Sticky going out.
Friendly spy plane inbound. Enemy napalm strike inbound. Heads up, enemy RCXD. Enemy spy plane incoming. Spy plane ready for deployment. Friendly spy plane inbound. The enemy captured the headquarters. It's down to this. Pick it up.
1 minute to 0.
Counter spy plane standing by. Headquarters secured. Headquarters located.
Enemy contact.
Heads up. Enemy RCXD. Enemy spy plane above. care package ready for direction. Show us where you want it. Time's almost up. Enemies jamming our radar. Friendly care package on the way. Our counter spy plane's in the air. Our spy plane's in the air. Our spy plane's in the air. Spy plane standing by. Spy plane ready for deployment. Our spy plane's in the air. Hostile RCXD spotted in your area. We didn't come here to fail. Bring it next time.